It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday. I'm Dave.
And I'm Craig.
And this is the Wizard Product Review on this week's show. And first up this week is signed by Craig.
Oh, why me? I can give you his website address. Marion. No, that's a girl's name. Mariam O'Gonigog.
That's
somebody.
You've probably got more of an idea than we have because we just watched the DVD and looked at the gimmicks, but it's signed. I think it's produced by Tango Magic.
It is produced by Tango.
Synopsisizers.
Okay, basically, you bring out a half dollar, a 50 cent piece of silver coin.
Yeah.
You bring out a half dollar, and you write the initials of the spectator on one side, and you do a drawing.
Kind
on
of
the
initial,
other side.
One initial.
Both sides are initialed, or a little drawing on it, or whatever. That is then put into the spectator's hand very cleanly. They hold their hand around it. No switches, it really is going into their hand.
Well, careful what you say, though, you know, but yeah,
they feel it go into their hand. And they see it going
into
their hand.
This is the effect we're talking about, yeah.
Good point. They close the hand around it. You then bring out another coin. It can be anything, but he brings out a quarter. Visibly, the
do a bit of magic for magicians up there.
Yeah, the quarter changes them to the into the half dollar.
Cleaner,
it's a nice transposition.
Yeah.
And then the half dollar vanishes right in front of your eyes, and there's another guy that's been holding a purse or something from the very beginning. He reaches into the purse and there's the signed coin. So it's a combination of coin to impossible location and a nice little transposition in there as well.
I liked it.
I'm amazed.
I thought it was quite good, actually.
You know, the amount of people that have come onto the YouTube or onto the Magic Cafe and said, you know, Dave Penn, he doesn't like coin magic.
No, I do like coin magic. I do certain things with coins. You know, I can do a roll-down flourish before a bottle production and that sort of thing, and do a coin-in-bottle routine. I do quite a lot with coins.
Because there's a discussion and going on Sean Farquhar's Facebook page about whether you...
Yeah, sorry, Sean.
about you know, what you actually think about coin magic and whether you should really be reviewing.
Yeah, Sean was a bit upset because I gave my opinion on it, even though I didn't like coin matrix. But, you know, that, as far as I'm concerned, it's like somebody just coming in the shop and going, should I buy that, Dave? And I'm just going to give my opinion. It's only our opinion, Sean. God, you think you'd have a bit more, you know, sort of security about yourself with all those trophies in your cabinet. You think you'd feel a bit better, but...
He liked me.
He liked you.
But yeah, he thought I was good.
It's all right. Put another DVD out soon. We'll give it a good review. Something like Torn to Pieces. I like that. That was good. Anyway, back to this.
Back to Signed.
Signed.
I think it's very clever. I didn't think I was going to like it. To be honest, it wasn't very inspiring, the packaging or anything like that. I didn't think it was going to be very good. But when I saw the method, I thought it was excellent.
Judging it just on the method, are you? You're going to have to be... careful here.
Why do I like it? That's a very good point.
I'll tell you why I liked it. As soon as I watched it, I wanted to play with it. You wanted to get it out. It's got quite a nice original gimmick coin that you get with it.
You want to
play with it. It's made up in half dollars and quarters at the moment.
But we have done a bit of research into this, and Tango are bringing out a version in UK coins as well.
Yeah.
Which is going to be the exact same thing, but it's going to be in 50 pences and 2 pences. So which will make a nice change, you know, the 50p changing into the 2p.
That'd be good. Pocket space, bit of an issue. You have to have some stuff.
There is bits over your body, but not just in your pockets, but in various other places on your body as well. But
it's a coin transposition. Is it as good? We've got to be careful what we say here because it's our own product. Coin transportation to sealed object, is it as good as Sleeve Star? I don't think it is.
I don't think it is either.
The nice thing is about it, it does happen in the spectator's hand.
And it's a lot easier.
It's a lot easier to master than Sleeve Star, but when you've got Sleeve Star down, anybody that went to Newcastle Convention and got Sleeve Star knows that it is a miracle in anybody's hands that takes the time to learn it. But the nice thing is with this, the change is perceived as happening in the spectator's hand.
And it is very nice. You put the half dollar in the spectator's hand. It looks like they close their hand around it. They feel the coin in there. And the next thing, they open it up and it's a completely different size and shape and type of coin. That is really, really
good.
It's
one of those things. You want to play with it. You want to do it. You say to yourself, I want to go out and try this, but I'm not sure how it would go down. You know, you see some tricks and you go, that'll work. As soon as I get that in front of an audience, that will storm it. I'm not sure.
And I think the problem is...
I want to try it.
Transpositions, I think the thing with a transposition, two coins changing places, I think it's heightened the more you have them change. And I think you've only got one transposition built into this.
Yeah.
And then you go straight to the ending where it goes into an impossible location. I think if he could have structured it so there were multiple transpositions, I think that maybe... Because the first time somebody sees the transposition, they're like, whoa, hang on, show me that again. It's kind of like the rule of three. And that can't be done with this routine.
I know... there's all these sort of, I forget what this
JW grip,
yeah, JW grip thing is and that kind of thing. When it goes into this kind of thing and it's up here, I think it's okay, magicians accept it. But we know how angly that sort of thing. And I think sometimes you can simplify things and it's better.
Yes.
Like, for example, anybody that knows what a palm-to-palm change is there, I think, you know, you're holding the coin, I'm holding a coin, just wiggle your thumb, you know, they change places.
Mm-hmm.
I think is sometimes a lot better from a performance point of view for spectators. You actually make it simpler, but the effect gets stronger.
And Marion
rather
choose,
than trying to do all this manipulation stuff up here, for me.
Marion chooses to use something with a JW grip, but you don't have to. You could just use a palm-to-palm change. And I'll say something right now. On there, he uses a move that is his own move called the gravity switch.
That's
and
very
I think
cool.
that is worth the price of the DVD alone to learn that gravity
very
switch.
Good.
You missed it completely.
I didn't even see a switch the first time. I thought, hang on, has it happened already? How's he going to carry on from this point? Missed it completely.
Excellent. Really, really good.
It's very good. You will want to play with it. It will be better when it's got English coins as well. At the moment, I think if I tried it and it went really well, I'd give it more. But at the moment, I'm going to give it 79%.
I'm going to give it 88%. I think it's a very good DVD. I think that if people buy it, they'll play around with it and I think they'll use it. And I don't think, the bottom line, I don't think people will be unhappy if they've bought it and they've watched the DVD. I think you'll get what you think you're going to get. Very good.
You give it an extra 20%. It's a coin trick.
Of course. Okay, so from the highs of Signed, we come crashing down to the lows of Spectre. By Spidey and Amir Latif, the guys that bought us Sub-Zero.
I think we've still got those balls somewhere in
the
our
ones
cabinet.
That we grew.
Yeah, they grew into like a deformed bit of DNA or
yeah,
something.
Yeah, that was terrible.
So, what's new with this DVD, Craig?
Absolutely bloody nothing, Dave. It's if you know the Glorpy or the Spirit Hank or the Devil's Hank, that's what this is. It's basically a Devil's Hank. And the first thing, Amir and Spidey, they sit down at the beginning of the DVD and they say, well, I don't want you to expect anything new here. We're not taking credit for the design of the Hank. We didn't create any of the routines on here.
We didn't invent that.
We didn't create any of the moves. So let me ask you a question, Spidey. Why the bloody hell did you bring it out? I mean,
I know why they brought it out.
Why? To
because
make
most Devil's handkerchiefs look like something from Chew's Miracles, that Chinese company, with like a dragon on or something like that. And it does look
not
a
all
bit
of them.
A bit more normal, because it's a bit more like a bandana.
It looks a bit like a bandana.
But it is a bandana.
It is a bandana. But the thing is, I've seen lots of Hanks like that, that have been designed to look like a bandana. That you know, they're acting like there's nothing like this out there at all.
And
there's
and
lots of handkerchiefs
got,
that look
to
like
be
bandana.
Fair, if you've got a routine where you need to use a Devil's Hank and you need something straight off the shelf, this is probably the best option
but
at the moment.
But the thing I want people to understand is they're not getting anything new here. They say,
yeah, but
you
sometimes
know,
you just need a Devil's handkerchief and you think that's what look Eugene Berger
yeah and
you know,
they reference Eugene
I saw
Berger.
Eugene Berger at the castle and he stormed it with this he got gasps as you know I think it enhanced like a spirit slate routine you know
yeah.
Eugene Berger
yeah.
right
look.
He's putting that routine together hang on let me speak he's putting the routine together he goes into a magic shop to get his prop wanders into World Magic Shop he's not going to go that's not what I need there's nothing new there because he wants it he's got a place for it in his act.
I know I love the Devil's Hank one of my favourite routines of all time
well this
JC
is probably
Wagner's...
one of the best versions of
JC
it because it's nice
something...
and modern
oh come on
and if you want to use JC Wagner's routine you're answering your own argument now you can do it with something modern because it's in this box.
But there's other hankies that are modern that you don't have to pay the price of getting a DVD that gives you bugger all information, to be perfectly honest. There's nothing on here, absolutely nothing.
But you get it all made up,
no
and it's
routines.
Not a normal handkerchief, you know, there is a gimmick, that sort of thing. You can gimmick the handkerchief for coins and rings as well.
Yes, you can. You know the old thing where you put a coin in the handkerchief and you whip it, the spectator holds the coin and you whip it away? Yeah, you can do that with it because of how the gimmick's made. But the ultimate version of that is if you've seen any ring by Richard Sanders, you can literally borrow any thickness of ring and you can have the spectator hold it, you can vanish it. That's the ultimate version of the ring vanishing handkerchief. This is a serious step backwards from that.
Oh, come on.
It is. It's a step backwards because they can't do that. You have to borrow a specific length, thickness of ring. Yes, you can change it over, but you can't.
It's
Let's be honest here. You can't go and have this handkerchief and vanish a ring and then go into the Devil's Hank routine because what you need to do is you need to go find a dark room, open up your handkerchief, take your one gimmick out, put your other gimmick in, and then you're ready to go. You may as well just buy a Devil's Hank, buy a ring vanishing handkerchief, and then be ready to do whichever routine you want to. So you've got to carry an extra handkerchief around. So what? Not good. Don't like it.
Can I just go on record now and say, I completely agree with Craig. I was lying before. I just like to see him get angry. 36%.
You.
Right, next up is Something for Nothing by Michael Murray.
Michael Murray.
And it's kind of like a reworking of a Paul Gertner effect.
It is.
I remember David Williamson doing on the Magic Comedy Strip, a fantastic effect.
I think over the years, a lot of people have done Unshuffled and
tried
put
to
it
do
in
it.
Their act. Yeah, well, it's not the easiest trick in the world.
Until you go and do it at a gig and go, oh, I've screwed up the Pharaoh Shuffle. And
yeah, that's it. It's
end
like,
up with
look,
like,
your tightrope, that trick is.
End
really
up
is.
With it not looking so good. But
Michael Murray's made it very, very easy.
Really? How easy?
Well, put it this way. I opened it up half an hour ago. I can do it already.
You can do it already?
I can do it already.
John, can we get it off the sticks?
Let's get it off the sticks,
let's
John.
Have a look at this.
So I've got a pack of cards over here. Now, I've got to tell you ahead of time, Dave, they're marked cards.
Right, okay.
But they're not marked on the backs. You know how cards are normally marked on the backs?
Yeah.
They're marked on the side of the pack. In fact, I've got the pack here. Hopefully you can see it.
Right.
On this side, it's actually marked with nothing. Hopefully you can see that. It's actually marked
yeah,
with nothing.
Yeah, I can see that.
That side's marked with nothing. And I've got
something. That's actually printed on the
yeah,
other side
printed,
of the cards.
And that side's got something printed on it.
Right,
you've got
okay.
nothing printed on one side. You've got something printed on the other. And using these marks, I can do a kind of pretty funky effect.
Right, so it's something or nothing.
It's something or nothing, exactly.
Yeah.
Hence the name of the trick.
Right.
Now, obviously there's 52 cards here. I'm going to get you to pick one. Now, sometimes magicians will they kind of run through the deck like this at the back. I'm going to openly do it at the front. I can't think of
that's
a fairer
fair.
Way, exactly.
That's fair, that
that's
is.
Fair.
Is that fair, John?
That's fair.
That's fair. So I'm going to run down the deck, Dave, and any time you want to, just say stop.
Stop.
Right there.
Is that
there.
Good enough for
that's,
you?
That's pretty much. I think you're one off, but that's
right.
Fine.
Okay.
Can you remember the
I've
card
got it.
For me?
Yes.
Fantastic. Now, in the original Unshuffled, you had to do a Pharaoh Shuffle like 5 times.
Right. Is this
is
your
very...
normal presentational pattern?
Oh, yeah. I do this to layman. This is how I perform it to layman. I get packs of cards out, I form a focus group, and we all start learning the Pharaoh. But with Michael's version, no Pharaoh required. I'm going to do an even more
should
complicated
shuffle. Should you discuss this
shuffle.
Afterwards and just
Why
do
not?
The trick
What?
First?
You do this. You take half the cards, you take some cards face up.
Some face up.
Well,
no,
not face
it's
up
it's
or
not
face
a slim
down.
Slim
I'm going into
shuffle. You're doing your
going
slim
into
routine.
Tribe of my I was going into Rocky Strong, I'm going mad. No, you do the shuffle
some
like
to
this.
The top, some to the bottom.
Some to the top, some to the bottom.
Yes.
And what that does is that makes a little something.
A little something.
A little something. You see, if I put half the cards down there, you can see that I've actually got a little something.
Oh, there's a little something.
I've made a little something. You like the gag?
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, yeah. It's in the instructions. But you know what?
Not two
only,
little something.
Two
oh,
little
no.
somethings.
Yeah.
But you know what? It may not look much, that shuffle, but what it does is right in front of your eyes, it takes the deck and puts it into new deck order. All of the
That's very
all
cool.
of the spades, all of the diamonds, all of the clubs, all of the hearts. And the idea behind this shuffle, it helps me find your card because you took a card out earlier.
No,
what
I
happens
I didn't take
is
that, didn't take it out,
didn't you? You're
no.
supposed to take it out. How's my acting? How'd that happen? if you had took it out, I could just look for the card that was missing and I could tell you what your card was.
Yep.
But as you didn't actually take it out, it looks like I'm going to have to use real magic. Now, you remember there was something written on one side?
Yep.
On the other side, we didn't have something. We had...
Nothing.
No, there was nothing. There was something. There's another guy. But the something is actually something. You see, if I take that nothing and rub it slowly, I want the camera to zoom in on this because this is the genius that is Michael Murray. I can actually take that and I can slowly start to turn it into the name of your card.
Oh.
The two.
That's
off
very good.
It,
we even got off.
We got off John.
Off John there.
We don't normally
didn't
get that
what
off
was
John.
Happen.
We don't normally get that off John. Now, what's nice about this?
That is very good.
That is an excellent routine.
Worker of the week,
without a question. Worker of the week. What
that
this,
is worker
what
of the
Michael
week.
Murray has done here is he has taken a modern classic. Unshuffled by Paul Gertner, and which normally
which was a great trick.
It's always been a great trick, but it is so hard. You have to do like 5 perfect Pharaoh shuffles, and like Dave said earlier, if you screw it up, that's it.
And not only that, you've got the subtlety with they can check both sides.
They can check both sides. So you see at the beginning something written on one side, nothing written on the other side, and at the end of the
and
routine...
And they can, you didn't
changed.
Do it, but they can rub both sides,
they can rub
they?
Both sides.
It's a normal deck on both
it's
sides.
It's a normal deck on both sides. They can rub both sides, and then this side changes into the two of hearts. It looks fantastic. And you know what else? When you do the unshuffled routine, in the performance, you have to do 4 or 5 shuffles.
Yeah.
With this, there's only one shuffle. There's just one shuffle, so it takes less time. There's less dead time that you have to fill with patter. It's more snappy. It's more direct. It's a very, very strong routine. And the resets All you have to do, that shuffling sequence, you just have to do that two more times and you reset back to the original order, ready to do again. So it takes like 30, 40 seconds to reset.
World Magic Store, we've actually got these in stock now. We've got an exclusive as well for the next sort of few weeks and on this item.
I would recommend, the two things I could say about this. One, on the packaging, Paul Gertner has actually said, very clever, you fooled me. So it's endorsed by Paul Gertner himself.
It's brilliant.
And from my point of view, I've been doing Unshuffled for years. I'm now taking Unshuffled out of my act and I'm putting in Something for Nothing by Michael Murray. I think it's a stronger, better, cleaner routine. It's more fooling. It's more commercial. And for that reason, I'm giving this 95%. It's my worker of the week. Michael Murray, you're an absolute genius. Thank you so much for releasing this to the magic community. I owe you one.
I'll give it 92%.
So next up we have the perfect nail bend. Probably the hottest trick in magic right now. Everybody's talking about it. There's a big buzz about the perfect nail bend. Everybody wants to know the question that's being asked on all the forums, is it practical? Dave?
Well, the thing is, one thing I'd say up front before we get to that is the actual packaging is terrible.
It really is awful.
For the quality of the gimmicks, the quality of the gimmicks is excellent. The gimmick is fantastic. The two gimmicks you get, I should say. The actual packaging, for something that's so good to just come with like a couple of bits of paper
and say,
make do with that.
It's the 21st century, and this is what you get. One side of A4 printed paper. That's it. That's just ridiculous.
So one thing we did at World Magic Store was John, who's actually been using this more than I have.
Yeah.
John, you've actually produced your own DVD, haven't you?
Yeah, we have.
He used to be the cameraman.
I know, and now he's becoming the talent. This is a little bit weird. Do we need to worry?
We'll be okay. We can start taking holidays, though.
Okay, good.
But the thing with the perfect nail bend is it does take a little bit of a setup.
It does.
As you know, because you've actually been out and used it. I forced you to use it and get into a little bit of bending.
And the reason is I didn't think it was going to be any good.
Yeah?
I didn't think it was going to be any good, so you forced me to take it out to my residency.
I told you what to do with it, didn't I? Which is not bend it in front of everybody, bend it in people's hands, and then kind of give it away afterwards.
Well, for the people that haven't seen it, do you reckon you could show it to me?
Well, I think we can actually do it. You've got a nail just there. And what I suggested to you was start rubbing it a little bit and get the bend to happen and then put it in spectators' hands and get everybody to put their hands over the top of it.
Yeah.
So in this position, you've got everybody's hands surrounding it at the table. That looks good for them because they can actually feel it bending. But just for you guys, we'll just do it like this. And you can see that just by rubbing it there,
exceptional.
Starting to go already.
It looks great.
It's starting to go. It's starting to go. Look, it's bending.
Hang on, I've got a line here. ENDB. Your mind psychologically rearranges the letters.
You have to do the Israeli accent as well. It's going. It's bending. And look, there's no heat. There's no heat there. There's no heat. And it really does look incredible. And it's going to bend a lot further than that. You can control as well how fast or how slowly it will actually bend. And they look like fencing nails. In fact, if you go to B&Q and go and ask for fencing nails,
this is
what
you get.
They look remarkably like these nails, actually, after a little bit of research. So what you can do, you can puncture two holes in your business card, and at the end, after going in your pocket and getting the business card out, you can thread that through and actually give it away to people.
Mm. It looks very, very good. You also get another gimmick, so that if you then want to straighten it back out, you can. I know you don't.
Immediately, you can straighten it out. Now, The main issue with it is
the practicality side of things.
The practicality side of it. You can. It takes about 2 minutes to set up. 2 minutes, is that fair, John? I want to be entirely fair. About 2 minutes. You don't have to be there for the whole 2 minutes, mm-hmm. do you?
No.
But sort of 15 seconds, go away, come back after 2 minutes, another 15 seconds, and you're ready to go.
I've been working this table hopping at some of my residences, and I've discovered that you can do it table hopping. We've come up with the technique that allows you to be able to do it almost literally from table to table with very little reset, which we put on the DVD.
Anybody that buys it from World Magic Store, the perfect nail bend, will send you the DVD for free.
The other issue people have had on the internet, they've been PMing me about saying, can you review this? A lot of people have said that the gimmicks aren't very well made.
Well,
we thought that initially, didn't we?
Yeah, until we discovered how to set it up and to do the initial setup that mm-hmm. takes about 45 minutes. For anybody that's played with this sort of equipment before, they'll know that you can use spray as part of the, I don't want to say too much on the internet, but you can use spray.
Yeah.
This is not the way to go.
It's not.
It's almost too much.
Yeah. It means that the gimmick won't work very well at that point.
Yeah. Whereas this, that kind of pace, that will sit out in the open for a long time. You can pick the nails up. Mm-hmm. You could have them wrapped in a towel. You could have a quiverque. You could choose one of the nails and then you can bend it in full view or in the spectator's hands like I got
and
you.
Look at
because they feel it happening.
And look at it, guys. It's a miracle. I mean, come on. If you've ever done any metal bending before, and I've gone on record on the show to say I don't do much, but I do coin vexed.
I made you do it, didn't I?
I do coin vexed. This is something that I'm going to carry on doing, I think, because it is a very strong effect. Yes, there are practicality concerns, but it's not as bad as you'd think. The gimmicks are very well made when you know how to use them properly. And it's a reputation maker.
How much was that key thing years ago?
The key thing and the fork thing were like £300-£500. And a nail is a more common object.
Yeah, especially if you have it in a bag with some other fencing nails.
Yeah,
you know
and
what
we've
I'm
talked
saying.
About that on the DVD as well.
And you can have the bag set up in a certain way, so you're ready to take them out of the bag and it's all set up.
Yeah,
you can be
exactly.
ready to go. Don't want to say too much.
I mean, you do you've more metal bending than most people
I
know.
You've got this sort of thing that you can do on the palm. You can rub it. You can inside their hands.
Can you think of many ways of bending something that look as visual as that or has an effect?
Not many, no.
Does not, is there?
It maybe looks really good. It's just the practicality issue that's going to stop people from buying it, I think. But for the gimmick is excellent. And if you want to do this effect, there's no better way to do it. I'm just sorry that they didn't take the time to put a DVD with it and make it look a little bit more special in the packaging. But at the end of the day, that's what you're paying for.
And anybody who gets it from World Magic Shop, we are going to include that DVD.
Yeah, you get that for
free. Of charge, obviously, so you can get our thoughts on it and kind of...
To be honest with you, even if it just had the one that bent and I could give it away on the business card with the two holes punctured in it, that would be enough for me for the money that it costs. I'm not really bothered about the one that goes from bent to straight. They are two separate effects.
I like that.
Not for me, but they're two separate effects. This is the effect I'm after. It gets frozen with the moment of magic illustrated there. They can see what's happened, and then you can give that nail away at the end just by going into your pocket and getting a business card with two holes punctured in it.
Excellent.
I think it's fantastic. It's not for everybody, so it's definitely not getting Worker of the Week, but I'm giving it 86%.
Yeah, I'm going to give it... 80%. I think it's a very good trick. If you buy it, there's no surprises.
That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. You can follow us in all the usual places.
YouTube, Facebook, Magic Cafe, wizardfx.tv. Are we updated on that?
Nearly.
Okay, cool. Search for us on iTunes. Just search iTunes for the Wizard Product Review. Please comment on the the YouTube site. We had so many comments. I think you pretty
we
much
did
won
I just Ma- won I just won the Matrix rant last
yeah,
week.
Yeah, just about won it.
But did it upset Sean Farquhar into the bargain? He got everybody to go on, but it didn't work. Sean,
are you gonna do the challenge today?
What challenge
you were talking about Sean Farquhar earlier?
What? I can't remember.
You said that you...
Is this something I said before we were filming and
now
it's in the show?
Yeah. You said that you would point at the camera and you'd say, I won the Matrix rant.
I won the Matrix rant. You can go on there, Sean, and try and get all your fans to beat me, but I still won. In your face, Farquhar. Is that what you thought I
wouldn't
say?
That was it. I didn't think you'd say it. So,
I'm joking, Sean.
And remember, I really liked it.
You got a lot of nice trophies. That came champion. Out wrong, didn't it? See you next week. I'm Dave.
I'm Craig.
We'll see you next week on the Wizard Product Review.